Hello my friends and welcome, my name is Dennis. Today we are going to review the motorcycle accident involving death casualties. So I would like to recommend you to remove your kids from the screen as well as your pregnant wives, because for sure it's gonna be a graphic content. Now guys, let's watch the crash video we have here. And I would like to say one thing. Our objective is not to blame the rider or the driver. Our objective is to find out what caused this situation to happen and how this situation could be avoided. So it's like a normal investigation process, and I hope you understand. Going a little bit further, I must say there were two persons on a motorbike, as you have just seen yourself, and one person died. It was a lady, the passenger of this motorbike. She died under the wheels of the lorry. And now my friends, let's start investigation.
So now guys, as you can see, there is a truck in the front and another truck is more faster and our guy is overtaking it. I'll stop here. And as you can see, the rider is moving really fast and it's overtaking the truck from the right side. The truck is very long and its speed is more faster compared to the truck which is in the front on the right line. So our rider just decides to overtake the truck in a blind spot, I would say. There is still enough distance available between those tracks, so the rider decides to overtake, to finish the overtaking of the left truck, and he did the mistake. He was confused about the truck speed on his left, or he was confused about the truck in the front, but he starts acceleration. But what happened? Then our rider started acceleration. As you can see, there is red lights on the track, so the truck in the front starts to brake, and our rider just couldn't do anything, so he just crashed between those tracks, and of course it's a tragic accident we have here. Now guys, let's discuss more detail. So we'll just draw a picture here. So here is our motorcycle. This green figure is a motorcycle. It's riding on the left side, and here are two trucks. The yellow truck on the left line and red truck on the right line. Our motorcycle is very close to the yellow truck, and the rider decides to overtake it from the right side, and it starts turning. But the rider did a very huge mistake here, because he didn't see the red truck on the right line, so he just starts the blind turn. I don't know why, but he did it. So he's now in the same situation, in the same position with the left truck, and so he tried to go to the left, but the second mistake he did, he didn't count that the left truck, the yellow truck, was still moving fast. And the second mistake was he starts acceleration, very fast acceleration. To accelerate so fast, to get into the gap between those trucks, the motorcycle needs to shorten the distance between the motorcycle actually and the truck, and this maneuver is not safe. So as you can see here, is I crossed the not safe maneuver and I left the blue maneuver, which is more safe compared to these green arrows, because if you start like he did, you'll shorten the possible brake distance between you and the truck or the obstacle or the object. And the truck in front, of course, it can move, it can brake, it can move to the left, you can do wherever it is, and you cannot predict its action. Also, this motorcyclist didn't see any obstacle ahead because he was really in front of the red truck and he got the blind spot. Also, we will talk about the blind spots we have here. There is a blind spot from the yellow truck, so the rider was in a blind spot of the yellow truck as well as of red truck, so nobody sees him in this situation. As you can see on a picture here, all bikes in this water are in the blind spot of the truck. The biker, the rider, was in a two blind spots of two trucks, so he did of course two major mistakes: the blind turn and acceleration.
I had a very similar situation myself while riding my motorbike just recently, and luckily I was filming the situation, and today I will show you how I avoided this close call, which is very, very similar to this crash video over here.
So guys, here I am riding my motorcycle. I don't really know the rider in front of me, so it's just a random motorcyclist. So here we go. Here, as you can see, all the situation, we have a huge truck on our left, so the guy just overtook it, and it's moving a little bit to the left, so the guy in front, I mean the motorcycle, is moving a little bit to the left, and I start to spot there is an obstacle in the front. So as you can see, there is possibly a truck, and I decided to maintain the same acceleration, the same speed, and I'll try to follow the rider, and the rider starts to go to the left very quickly, and as I can see here, there is a one truck in the front with a left turn signal, and I was really confused because guy in front of me, the motorcyclist, he needed now to turn to the left line once again, so he needed to change two lines. As for me, I don't have any options because I can see in my line, in right line, I can see there is one more truck in front of the truck which is turning, so there will be two line blocked for me, and I have the truck on my left, so for sure I will not have another option but to brake. So I just use my brakes, I brake a little bit. But also I was very surprised because the truck driver on my left, somehow he sees me by the time, and he saw me and he started to brake as well, because he just saw that I will follow the motorcycle in the front, so probably I'll get into under his wheels as well. So guys, there is a short explanation about this situation happened to me. So my option was to use variant A to go to the left and overtake the truck from the right, and to follow the motorcycle in the front. But the idea just ruined by the truck in front, which was turning to the left. So the only option I have, just not to crash into the truck, is to use brakes. So I always leave this option for me, so always calculate the possible braking distance enough for the obstacle in the front, so I never rush up, I never have one variant, because with one variant you can lose, as a rider did in our crash video investigation.
So guys, we have just discussed the situation in total and what action should be done to prevent the similar situation while you riding your motorbike, because this can happen to everyone. But I would like to say one more thing, guys. According to statistics, the motorcycles has the highest risk volume from all the transport you can travel the world. So please, when you ride your motorcycle, understand the risk you can face on the road. Understand it, control it, and take responsibility for your life and life of your passenger. Because on this video, the woman died not because of her failure, but the failure of her husband, the rider. The only her failure was she got into this motorcycle. They had the kid left behind, 4-year-old kid, and the rider survived, and somehow he had to live with this.